diferente. Como luz amaneces primero. Todo es diferente. Y mi viaje contigo es ligero.
Yo por ti sé que vi un mundo en primavera. Y te vi para mí. ¿Quién más si no eras solo tú? Va a amanecer, en el alma yo te encontré.
You're more than qualified for this job, Emilio.
Really, ma'am? Thank you. I've always said you can't improvise experience, right? In this kind of company, well, I guess all the jobs are equally important. It's sort of like a gear, you know? Where if everything works out right,
Emilio,
you can achieve something really nice,
Emilio.
Like a collaboration.
Emilio.
It's harmonious,
Emilio.
You know? You work...
Emilio.
Yes, ma'am?
You lost me at gear. I didn't get any of that. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, ma'am. It's just that I'm a little nervous as well.
What I do see here, Emilio, is that, you don't have any experience in this field of work.
Oh, no, none at all. But I've always wanted to work in something like this.
Oh, really?
Yes, ma'am, ever since I was little. Look, I was born for this. And if you give me the chance, I would love to try it. And to be perfectly honest with you, I do kind of need the money. I just found out I'm a father, and I don't know my daughter that well. That's why I came back to the country. And, well, I want to give her the life she deserves, and although I don't know her well enough... And what I want to say is that, well, I would love to work here, ma'am. I have always dreamed of this. I have knocked on so many doors. And it's practically in your hands, ma'am.
Well then, welcome back to your country. And welcome to Copito.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay then. I'll see you tomorrow at 8, okay? Don't forget to stop by Castilla's office. You'll have to leave the usual papers with him, okay? Like your resume, your police clearance...
Oh, yeah, ma'am. The thing about my police clearance is that I haven't gotten it yet because since I just got back to the country...
Well, you better get it soon and bring it, right?
I lied, ma'am. Well, the truth is I do have it, but every time I present it, they close the door in my face.
Is your record really that bad?
Ma'am, as soon as I set foot in the country, I was arrested. The truth is, I was set up and I brought a suitcase filled with dollars and I had no idea, ma'am, but I cooperated with the authorities. And eventually they caught the guy who tricked me. But the truth is that my resume is tainted. And that's the whole truth. I'd rather tell it to you now, ma'am. And if you do choose to believe me, well, good. And if not, then thank you for being so kind to me.
Emilio, I think you should never judge a person based on a mistake from their past, yeah? And if you tell me you didn't make any mistake, that he didn't do anything, then I definitely believe you. So are
really?
We still on for tomorrow?
Well, you don't even have to ask me that, ma'am. Thank you so much, really, from the bottom of my heart.
Okay. go on then. That would be all.
Thanks.
Princesita.
Guess what? Mission accomplished.
What?
Don't you see the look of satisfaction I have of happiness?
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
That's great, right? So you got a girl to work for you?
No. Not exactly a girl. Listen, Mario. What I'm saying is, I've got a male secretary. His name is Emilio Romero. And well, you can tell me if he's your type, huh? You see that? Did you like him? No? You didn't like him? Oh, I'm sorry.
how delicious this is. Look, it's broccoli, 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 coli.
Okay, Vale, so tell me, what school do you go to?
To Santa Rosa.
Wow. And do you have a lot of friends?
Yeah, about 5.
Wow. And what do you like most in your school?
Playing.
Really? And do you like chocolate? Because tomorrow I can bring you a really big one like this.
Oh no, I can't eat chocolate.
In this house, we do not consume empty calories.
Well, okay, darling. Since I guess you're all done, let's go and wash our hands and teeth, cause the dragon is going to wake up and eat the princess on the count of 3. 1, dun, 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 2, here he comes, and 3, yeah. No, you better run now, yeah, here he comes. Oh,
what did you want to tell me?
That I got a job as an accounting assistant.
Oh, really?
Yes. Why the tone of doubt? Of course I did. And the best part is that I can grow in the company. Maybe I'll become the chief of accounting. Now I can take care of Valentina.
Hold on there. What about living? I mean, my daughter is a princess. You know she can only be in a good place. Not in some place filled with pollution. Our daughter is allergic to everything, you know.
Well, I'll take care of that part tomorrow.
We'll have to see about that because with you, you never know.
I just wanted to say hi.
I hope you arrived okay in Cartagena. I had a strange day,
to tell you the truth. Starting tomorrow, I won't have a female secretary, but a male secretary. What do you think? I think it'll be the perfect solution for the problem with your brother. Oh, I'm very, very tired. I'll call you tomorrow to give you all the details. Have a good night, babe. Kisses, kisses. I love you.
Hey, be careful with this one, please. Hey, this one.
Here, let me help you.
Oh, thank you.
No, you shouldn't be doing that. It's bad for your back.
It's just that it almost fell.
Come on in and sit down for a while.
You're very kind. I'm sorry, I don't have anything to thank you with right now.
Oh, no, don't worry about it. There's no need. I'm glad to have helped you.
Hey, but you're not from around here. I've never seen you before.
No, but I'd like to be. This neighborhood is actually quite nice.
This neighborhood is great. It's so resourceful, and it's really a shame that I have to go.
Listen, forgive my curiosity, but why do you have to go?
Oh, well, the bank is taking my apartment, and before they take everything away, I'm taking what I can to save it.
And so the apartment's going to be empty?
Yes, I have no one to leave it to. Why, do you have any ideas?
Well...
Well, come on in, young man. And here it is. This is the apartment. I'll be leaving you a mattress, that furniture that's a little old, but you know, it still works fine. And there are the light bulbs.
Thank you very much.
Oh, no, young man. The way I see it, if I can't enjoy it, then I should let someone else like you do it.
Huh? I'm eternally grateful.
Although I'm afraid that you might not enjoy it for long because the bank could just come along and take everything.
Oh, that's not a problem.
It's not?
No, tomorrow I start a job at Copito Industries, the one with the little dog.
Ah, yes, I see.
And, with my first salary, I hope I can rent this apartment.
Well, I hope you can. And anyway, I really wish you a lot of luck, young man. Oh, and by the way, here are the keys.
Thanks again.
You're very much welcome.
Good luck.
And good luck to you.
Thank you.
Hello? Hey. Hello, Mr. Palacio.
Castillo, and you are?
Emilio Romero. How do you
do? Oh, Mr. Romero, pleased to meet you. How do you do?
I'm fine.
Miss Antonia gave me instructions to hire you, and here is your contract. Here it is. Have a look, sir.
Oh, how wonderful.
Read it. I can't see.
Emilio Romero,
then
yes,
sir. Then that's the one.
Great, so it's all ready. This is my kind of company, you know.
I must confess, Mr. Romero, that in the 20 years I've been here in this company, this is the first time I've drawn out a contract like yours. Well, I guess the times have really changed, right? We have to keep an open mind. We are very forward-thinking here, sir. But read it, and sign it.
Yes, of course. So excuse me for a minute, please. Mr. Castillo, there's a small problem with the contract.
A small problem?
Well, yes, this one. It says here that I'm going to be a secretary.
And what's the mistake?
Well, it says secretary for the commercial department.
No, no. Mr. Romero, I assure you there is no mistake. Miss Antonia gave me the order to draw out your contract as such.
But what do you mean? So I'm a secretary?
Yes, for the commercial department.
Good morning, I said.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Mario.
Well, it may be good for you, sister-in-law.
Oh, yeah, but I thought you would be happy because we have a new secretary. I mean, male secretary, right? Hey, did you know he starts today?
You still have that absurd idea, Antonia.
You know what? I don't think so. Actually, the more I think about it, I think it's an absolutely wonderful idea.
Well, I think it's ridiculous. Because a male secretary is an abomination, a disrespect, a perversion.
To me, a refreshing change that was totally necessary. And you know, there's no point in continuing to discuss it. You're absolutely right.
Antonia, you can't do this.
I already did.
You can't do this to me!
But I already did. Besides, I don't understand what's the big deal. Why so scared? What's the problem, Mario? Suddenly the secretary is your type?
Watch
yourself. Who knows?
You better watch what you're insinuating, because I'm a man, Antonia. I have a long line of secretaries after me. Barbie! Come over here.
Oh. Barbie?
Yes, Barbie. Yes, pick that up. And Barbie, would you tell Antonia who's the total stud in this company?
Mr. Felix?
Antonia! Barbie!
I'm sorry. You see.
Go over there.
Mario, what do you think you're doing?
What
How
am I
are
doing?
Going to put Delfina in that situation?
Yes, I will put her in that situation.
Well, the people are here. It's time for the meeting, shall we? Oh.
Good morning, sir. How are you doing today?
How do you do? Good morning. Come this way.
Oh, this way, sir.
This way, please.
Good morning.
No, there must be some mistake.
No, no.
You're confused.
You speak to me that way. Don't speak to me at all.
Oh, wait a minute.
Have
wait
some
a minute.
Respect.
No. I spoke to Mrs. Antonia yesterday, and we spoke about me becoming
Don't
the accounting
raise your
assistant
voice
here.
At me. We are in an office, mister. And to tell you the truth, sir, it sounded very odd to me too, but Miss Antonia requested it. And she let me know via email as well as personally and over the phone too, your contract is for provision of secretarial services in the commercial area.
Oh, no,
do you understand?
A secretary? Come on. No, what kind of insult is this, man?
Oh, no, don't
Come
you
on,
wave
do
your
I look
hands
like a secretary
at me.
To you?
Don't throw the contract at me. Show some respect.
Come on. Do I look like a secretary? No.
Come back
I want
here.
To speak Hold to Mrs. Antonia. Sir. Do you know where Mrs. Antonia is?
No. Don't listen
well,
to
why
me.
Why won't anyone tell me? Come on, please.
No.
Don't hide her
sir,
from me.
You cannot
why don't
go
you
in
know?
Call the
Does
court.
Anyone here know?
Sir.
I need to speak with Mrs. Antonia.
Will you
hey, you.
Sir,
you. Do you know where Mrs. Antonia is? Oh, no. I'm not going to be a secretary. No way. And what are you doing here? I'm not even talking to you. Where is Mrs. Antonia?
Watch,
just leave me alone if you're not going to help.
What is your problem?
Come back here.
Castillo, relax.
What's
going on?
What was that all about?
It's very important to keep in mind for this negotiation that the increase in the customs duties.
Well,
will
I'm not, Doctor. Whether you like it or not, nobody's going to stop me.
No,
what are you doing?
No, you can't come in.
I need to speak to her right now.
Please.
All right, just 2 seconds, ma'am. I won't take any more of your time, okay? Please, I need to speak to you urgently. No one will let me talk to you, and they want to throw me out of the building. 2 minutes, okay? That's all I need, ma'am. Come on, please, ma'am. Please.
Gentlemen, you'll have to excuse me, okay? I'm going to be out for 2 minutes, but it won't take long, okay?
I'll take over.
So embarrassing.
Gentlemen,
thank you.
Silence! Get over here.
Huh. Oh.
You are showing a total lack of respect, sir. We will not tolerate your kind of behavior here in this company.
Yes.
Get out now, or we will have somebody throw you out.
Hold on, everyone. The one who's being disrespected here is me. And another thing, let me just tell you that the way that you welcome your guests in this company is deplorable.
Oh, how could you say that? I told you that you couldn't go in because there was a meeting going on in there.
That's right. You said you were going to call security and have me thrown out.
Well, no.
Security over here.
Security reasons. No.
I have rights, you know.
Calm down, would you please? Emilio, I don't understand anything. Please, what is going on to make such a scandal about?
Listen, ma'am, I'm so sorry. Just give me a moment alone and I'll be able to explain everything that's going on.
No.
I'll give you the time here. You just dragged me out of a very important meeting, Emilio, so you have 2 minutes. I'm listening.
Forgive me, but look, today I arrived at the office and this man was offering me a contract as a secretary. Me, a secretary. There's a misunderstanding here, ma'am.
No.
Huh?
There's no misunderstanding here, Emilio.
And I told him so, Miss Antonia, but he was so enraged. Look at him. He even wants to hit me. He wants to hit me.
What do you mean there's no misunderstanding?
It's not, Emilio. The job I interviewed you for was for a secretary for the commercial department.
Well, is there something wrong with it or what?
See, that's what I said.
You didn't know?
Well, of course I didn't know. If I had known, then I wouldn't have accepted. I mean, really, do I look like a secretary? Me?
Hey,
me,
secretary?
That's all right.
I'll have you know it. I am overqualified for these things.
What is your problem with that position?
Yeah, I can do a lot better than that. So there. How do you like that?
Well,
look, you know what? I'm sorry for the misunderstanding, but I thought you and I were on the same page.
Well, no, ma'am, no. You'll have to forgive me, but...
But what's the matter? The position of a secretary to the commercial department is also a very important...
Oh, yes, that's right.
Super important.
We're valuable, you know?
Very important, but not for me, you know. I will never, ever be a part of that guild of secretaries there. You know what? I may be in need of this, but not that badly, so you just stay out of this.
You, sir, all right, ma'am.
Hey, mister, you should shut yourself up, all right? Get out of here.
Come on,
yes, bring him out. Take him out.
Come on.
Out you go.
Let me go.
Wait.
Shut up, everybody. Come on. Shut up. Stop it.
Come on. Let us give you another chance, ma'am.
Take it
please.
And the Copito toilet paper doesn't scratch.
Okay, Mario, thank you. Gentlemen, please forgive me for the setback. Thank you very much for waiting.
Don't worry, it's not
a problem. Oh, don't worry. It's all right.
Excuse us for a second, please. Antonia, if you need more time to iron out that embarrassing incident, you can go ahead and take it.
No, Mario, thank you.
So do we have a secretary?
No. No, not yet. Okay. Gentlemen, where were we? We were talking about customs tariffs, right? So the new law...
Oh, there's no need. There's no need. I can walk out on my own, okay? There's no need to push either. Go humiliate someone else after all my effort to become a secretary. A secretary? No. No way. What? You want to insult me too, huh? You want to push me around too? Push me. Insult me. Apparently that's what I'm here for, right?
No, sir. I came to see if you were all right. If you needed anything. That's all.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just upset because of everything that happened in there.
Olga Linares. But everyone calls me Olguita.
Pleased to meet you, Olga. Emilio Romero. And don't worry, I'm fine, okay?
Are you?
Fine, I'm ticked off. I'm unemployed. Now I'm banned from this company. I insulted Miss Antonia, who had nothing to do with this mess with the secretaries. And I guess I must have blacked out. I'm sorry about that.
So does that mean you're going to work with us?
What's the matter with you? Me, a secretary? Oh, no. Well, no offense, okay?
Oh, I'm not offended by that. Don't worry.
We'll see what the future holds. I wish you the best, Olga. Goodbye.
Bye, Emilio.
Hello. Can I have the newspaper? Thank you very much.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for coming.
Thank
for
you
me.
So much.
So,
it was good to meet you.
Start using your toilet paper today. You'll love it. Say, Antonia, that your plan to have a male secretary to the rescue came out wrong. Well, not wrong, it came out pathetic. Because the idea of a man dressing up as a woman to be a secretary is never going to work.
Look, Mario, Emilia might have left, okay? But I'm not going to give up this early. From now on, I plan on getting a secretary that isn't good enough for you.
You are not gonna find one. And I swear, the only person you will get for us is someone who'll do a bad job. Why don't you look for one, Antonia? Or maybe you can let me look. Castillo has lots of resumes, and there are very good ones. Resumes, I mean.
Yes, Miss Antonia?
Yes, a favor.
Do you know if there is any other job available for Mr. Romero?
Oh, no, Miss Antonia. The truth is we already hired Mr. Aguirre as accounting assistant, and that was the only job opening we had.
But isn't there any chance in another department? Maybe in purchasing or right here in this warehouse?
No, Miss Antonia. You know that the company rules are very strict in reference to hiring new personnel, and we already have a full quota. Plus, you have to wait till the end of the fiscal year for new hires and new job openings.
That's very clear to me. Mm-hmm. The thing is that this was my last shot.
Mm-hmm.
But, oh well. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Castillo.
You're welcome.
Castillo.
Yes, Miss Antonia?
Another favor. Would you by any chance know if Romero left a contact number?
No, Miss Antonia, but you saw how that man behaved. He was very temperamental and he almost assaulted me. Yes. He was so upset he didn't leave any contact information.
The thing is that I think he felt very bad, and I wanted to maybe apologize to him.
Well, it's a shame I can't help you, Miss Antonia.
Well, what can we do? But thanks anyway.
You look very beautiful today.
Ah, thank you.
Excuse me.
All right.
Hello.
Hi. I was passing by and I wanted to say hello.
Yes, but it's just that Valentina hasn't come home from school yet.
It's just that I haven't learned her schedule yet, so...
Yes, I can see that. And weren't you supposed to be working?
Yes. Well, the thing is that things got complicated today at the office, and so here I am.
Have you had lunch?
No.
Come on in. If you want, there are some lettuce there, cucumbers. I'm not sure what you want, but you can fix yourself a salad.
No, it's okay.
Or would you like some rose petals with honey? They're very tasty.
Oh, no, really, it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
I forgot to tell you, I spoke to the lawyer.
The lawyer?
Mm-hmm.
How come? Are you in trouble?
No, not at all. For Valentina.
But a lawyer? What for? But I did tell you that I could take care of everything.
I know you will, honey, but I need you to sign an agreement where you promise to pay for half of the child's expenses. That's the law. Are you sure you don't want anything else? Come on, I'll fix you a salad. There's cucumber, tomatoes.
Okay, 12 o'clock. What happened? Why didn't you tell me? I would have paid a cameraman.
Oh, the poor guy. I think that when they told him he was going to be the new secretary, he immediately pictured himself in high heels, a skirt, stockings, and a pretty blouse.
Too.
And I'm sorry to say this, but I think the reason why he acted that way was because he got mad. You know, I think he's really sweet and sensitive. How did he act?
Well, you said he was sweet and sensitive, right?
Mm-hmm,
so I
mm-hmm.
understand that no man with a minimum amount of testosterone would accept a secretary's job. That is a job for women who like to chit-chat and talk on the phone. That's right.
What's the matter
with you? What's the matter
with you?
You
show us
some
respect.
You are invading my territory.
No,
please, with all due respect, the energy in this office is very bad and negative, you know. Let's take it all out. All together now. Come on. Shoo. Out of here.
Don't shoo.
Out of here. Then I'm going to have to change my aura, and you know that's going to take some time.
No. Don't discredit our job. All you do here is warm up your seats with just one brain cell. Huh?
Show some respect, young lady.
You sounded like the guy who barged in earlier, saying that he was meant for better things than being a secretary. He's a chauvinist. How shameless.
Melody, may I please have a sip of your juice, please? I'm really thirsty.
Hmm? Didn't your mom pack your lunch for you?
Well, I think you all know that I get paid very little here, honestly, yes. And my mother's medicine is very expensive, so last night we didn't buy oranges to make juice, or the medicine, or the juice. Well, we're broke, you know, and since I don't have anything to drink, well, maybe you could just give me a sip, please.
Put it that way.
Oh, yes, why don't they
put
all
that
in
your
ass?
She doesn't do anything for me while he does. I'm so unfair.
Oh, yeah, it's a good thing that guy left. Maybe I can get my job back, because over there in the garage, I'm starting to get circles under my eyes. It's getting so dark. Look at the huge circles.
Oh,
look,
who are you?
Look at this.
Obvious that you're deteriorating, Missy.
Horrible.
Well, honestly, it seemed like he really needed the job.
Oh, no, I can't believe it. You're trying to defend that guy.
No, Delfinita, it's just that you shouldn't judge
like
the man.
Like the long walk I have to take just to get
boots.
Some water. Oh, milady, come on, please, just give me a
gentlemen,
sip.
Gentlemen, excuse me, but it smells like food in here, and it's not right for our offices to smell like this. That's what the cafeteria is for, so move out to the cafeteria. Everyone, go move into the cafeteria.
Wait, I only have this much food left.
Go take your food
look.
To the cafeteria, all right? Don't be so stubborn.
These are the school expenses.
A year?
A month. It's one of the most exclusive schools, and the girl can only have the best. Why? You afford it? Because if that's the case, just say it. How do you want to have ride if you don't have
obligations? Okay, enough, Lorena. I'm here because I want to pitch
in. This is for transportation.
Oh, come on. This is ridiculous, Lorena.
This is for her groceries. Expensive because it's all of the best quality. It's imported. We can't just give her garbage.
I know, but this is ridiculous.
Her prepaid medicine is expensive.
Wow.
We use this much for educational toys. This part was missing. This is for her clothes. I buy her 2 outfits a week. It's also expensive because the girl only wears cotton and synthetic products of the best quality. Cheap clothes give her allergies.
Where are you? Lorena, I'm sorry, but all of this is ridiculous. I don't know how you can afford all of this every month.
Franklin is an excellent publicist. He's never had a problem for paying everything for the girl. Something you've never done. That's why the child adores him.
Well, no,
do you have a problem?
No. I do accept that, Lorena, but he's her stepfather, and I'm her father.
That title, it has to be earned,
well,
you know that?
Obviously, it has to be,
but... Well, look at it however you want to.
But why do I have to pay for
mommy,
all of this?
Mommy!
Hello, darling. You're home early, huh?
Hi there, little princess. How was school today?
Fine. Can you come with me to my room, please?
Yes, honey. Let's go.
Bye.
There's more. Let's go, sweetheart.
Bye-bye.
What's wrong, my darling?
Did he come here for me?
No, sweetheart. He came to talk to me.
Well, it's just that I'm so embarrassed around him, Mommy.
Oh, don't worry, sweetheart. It's okay. Whenever you want to be with him, all you have to do is tell me.
Not yet.
Don't you worry, my love. It's okay. Understand?
I think I'll be leaving now.
Aren't you going to have lunch?
No. I have an important errand to run. Look, little one. You know, when I was downstairs, a little bird came around asking about you.
About me?
Yes, you. And he stayed. Pick a hand. Go on, pick a hand. Nope. Ah, yes, that one. Look, this little bird is going to take care of you. And you have to take good care of it too, okay? It eats a lot, so take care. I love you very much.
Okay, let me see that, Valentina. What nerve. Take out your math book and do your homework, okay? Emilio! Emilio, hold
what?
On!
What? What do you want?
Emilio, please! Emilio,
what?
This is very
yes,
serious! Why did you leave this lying around?
I don't need to know what every cent is for, okay? If you say that's what my daughter spends every month, then that's what she spends, all right? So now I guess the only thing that I can do is to try and come up with half of that each month, and you can continue handling the money like you've always
Wait
been.
A minute, this is a legal
what?
Document in which you agree to pay for Valentina's child support. For every year you aren't here, you have to
well,
pay.
Well, I can't pay for this.
No, I don't care. That's not my problem. If you want, pay in installments. You want to be with your daughter, don't you?
All right.
Yes, you do. Okay, fine. Include the complete package. While you weren't here and Franklin hadn't come into my life, I looked after the girl. She never lacked a thing. Now it's your turn.
All right, I will. I'll see to everything.
Okay, see you.
All right, fine.
Good morning, Gen Z.
What's so good about it?
Wow, you're in a bad mood. What did you have for breakfast, snakes? Why are you talking
Mario,
to me like
do you
that?
Think it's fair to be cooped up in this terrible place, surrounded by rude truckers who want nothing but gawk at me, and plus they smell like grease?
Oh, Gen Zita, you want me to get you in a good mood, don't you?
I want my job in the commercial department back. That's where I belong.
Look at the bright side, darling. You're here, and we're going to experience new places that we haven't enjoyed yet, huh?
You're impossible, Mario. You're only thinking about dirty things. What about my feelings?
Jen Cecita, come on. I'm not thinking of dirty things. That's not why I'm here. If you want, I'll propose something.
What would that be?
Why don't we finish what we started, darling? Why don't we, why don't we get into the loading elevator and finish what we started last night? We can do stuff and then talk about feelings, okay?
You think so? It's just that I'm afraid of getting in one of those things, sir.
Really? No, nothing is going to happen. I'll hold your hand from the first to the second. You won't get loaded. Ha! Ow!
What did you think? That I'm stupid? I'm an idiot? Until you get me my job back, nothing.
Come on.
Don't try to trick me. You know what my worth is. I don't deserve this, so it's your call. It's all up to you now.
Are you that hard to convince, Jensi?
A lot more.
Huh?
Hello?
Hey, honey, what are you up to?
Looking for some takeout numbers. I have them all in a file, and it seems that Jensi threw them all away. I don't know what she could have done with it. What about you? What are you up to? Did you have lunch already?
No, not yet. I just finished a meeting. And I'm actually rushing to go to another one, you know?
Oh, honey. Give yourself at least some time to eat, don't you think?
Yes, don't worry. I'll grab something to eat, and you? I'm sure. If you don't eat lunch right now, you won't eat all day.
Oh, honey. I don't have time. Besides, I'm not hungry, you know? I'm kind of angry.
How come?
Well, I'm angry because all along I thought I had a perfect solution to Mary's secretary problem here at the office.
And tell me, what was the solution, huh?
To hire a male secretary instead of a female secretary.
Are you in the meeting already? I thought I heard someone in the background.
No, it's just the coffee lady. No one really. No.
Well, it turns out that a person I'd spoken to quit before even beginning because he thought that a position was for an accounting assistant and not for secretary of the commercial department. So now he's going to put up with Mario.
Well,
try it.
Ignore him. He loves that. Honey, I have to go. The meeting is going to start. The investor actually has the microphone in his hand.
Okay then, sweetheart. Good luck.
I'll do everything I can.
Big kiss. I love you.
I love you, my beautiful.
Oh, you love her, do you?
Not her, you. Oh,
you're ridiculous. No. You love talking to her in front of me. Why do you like to make me so jealous? You are so evil.
I don't know, but I love it. Do you have a problem
with
that?
You know how that makes me feel, don't you?
You like to tease me, don't you?
You're bad. I should spank you.
No. What I need you to do... I need you to give me another report, okay? As many times as necessary. I'll call you back, okay? What is it, Mario?
Sister-in-law, how are you?
I'm working. How about you?
Antonia, I was just thinking about the embarrassing incident we had with Jensi, so the best thing we can do is make up and start over. Take it like a misunderstanding. Jensi will get her old job back, and you don't have to get anyone. Because the resumes, the interviews, it's very time-consuming for you.
Okay.
So what do you say? We can start from zero, as if nothing had happened.
Third time's a charm, right? You know what? I think I'm going to put a little tape recorder so that each time you insist, the recorder can say no.
Antonia, you will never see me in such a compromising position again, I promise.
Mm-hmm. Of course, in that position, I imagine not. But in some other, I will. Hmm? You have some nerve, Mario. And I'm sick and tired of this subject, so will you please drop it once and for all?
Open your heart and stop holding a grudge.
I see. As opposed to the use and... the abuse you give your secretaries. Well, I need someone to be my right hand. I need someone to be my eyes and to be on top of everything. And Jensi simply doesn't meet any of those requirements. What can I do?
Jensi deserves another chance, Antonia.
Oh, please, she had 10,000 chances.
So what? Another chance won't do you any harm.
Mario, this is a very important labor issue for me, so I won't budge. What do you want me to do?
Have you ever wondered about something, Antonia? That maybe you're the one with the problem here? Yeah. Because nobody's good enough for you. You're the workaholic.
If you're here to criticize me, you can leave, okay?
Okay.
Is that making up for you? Is that making up to you? In other words, since you didn't get it the nice way, you'll do it the hard way, huh? You know what? Get out of here.
What?
I said get out of here, please.
So I came for wool and got sheared, huh? Someday.
Yes, sure, no problem, miss. Yes, of course. No salary? Miss, for the position of operating assistant... Yes, of course. A backhoe? Well, no, but I can learn. Hello? My last job? In New York, yes. delivering pizzas. Oh. Thank you. Hello, good day. I'm calling about that ad in the paper. Oh, so the position has been taken. No, no, thank you. Hello, ma'am.
Hello, neighbor.
Oh, you live here?
Oh, my goodness, do I live here? Oh, yes, of course I live here. What about you?
I just got settled in. Pleased to meet you, Emilio Romero.
Emilio what?
Romero.
I'm Gertrudis, but they call me Dudis.
Oh, it's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs.
A pleasure. What's your name?
Emilio Romero.
Dudis. They call me Gertrudis. And what happened to the other neighbor? I heard he had trouble with the bank or something like that.
Well, okay, I'm going to be honest with you. The thing is, your ex-neighbor, as you so well put it, kindly let me stay here until the bank comes over to repossess it.
Oh, poor man. I'm so sorry. He was such a good man. Anyway, what is your name again?
Emilio Romero.
Gertrudis. Goodbye. Dudis. Gertrudis.
Goodbye. Suspended? No, what is this? Suspension? Everything suspended! Everything suspended?
Oh,
what?
No. My boy, this apartment sure is empty.
Excuse me, ma'am. How did you get in here? Well, the apartment is all disheveled because I just got here from the United States and I haven't had the time to fix anything or clean it up.
And you don't even have a pot.
I have a couple, but they're busy with some leaks, as you can see.
Oh, son, come. I'll fix you some soup to warm you up because, you know, the night is freezing.
Oh, that's very kind, but I don't want to impose.
Oh, you know, a donkey died of embarrassment. Come and help me fold some clothes. It's just this rheumatoid that's acting up. Oh, my, is it rheumatoid or gout? What is it? Oh, anyway, I feel so good that it's probably nothing. Come on. But you go out through your door and I'll go out through mine. Okay?
Hi, girlfriend. Tell me what's up.
Fine.
What are you up to? Are you busy or do you have time to grab something to eat?
Oh, no. But what do you mean? Aren't you at work?
No, I'm tired. Plus, I didn't have lunch today. I wanted to go to a restaurant. They're opening, you know?
Oh, girlfriend, I'd love to go with you right now, but...
Well, unfortunately, well, today I have to, I have to go to a funeral.
What do you mean, Paula? Why didn't you tell me?
Oh, it's not that important. It's the
cousin of an uncle, and he wasn't at all that close to me.
Hey, Foxy, tell Grace to fix us something to eat, and...
Who are you with?
No one. It's an uncle who just came here to pick me up.
Hey, Paula, if you want, I can go with you to the funeral parlor.
You know, I'm here for you. And maybe you need company.
No, babe. I won't put you through
that. Besides, it's just boring, so why don't you just stay there and relax?
And maybe I'll call you later, okay?
Whatever you say. So let me know if anything comes up.
Okay, goodbye.
Why didn't you tell me, silly?
Oh, so now I'm the
silly. Oh, no, it's me. Don't come any closer. Don't come any closer. I said don't come any closer.
Oh, you naughty lady. Okay, maybe a little closer.
Sit down, young man.
Mrs. Dudis, you always startle me. Weren't we going to have some soup?
Was it soup? Oh, yes, the soup. I made some. I made it.
Well, I'll accept a drink if it wouldn't hurt. If that's all right with
you. Go on, kid. It's great for the cold and for troubles, too.
Can you tell I have problems?
Oh, my dear. Anyone that lives in an apartment that's about to be seized and doesn't have a bed to lie on has problems.
Well, let me tell you something. My life has drastically changed, you know. 180 degrees. A week ago, I was an immigrant in the United States, and, well, you could say that I had a modest but legal job, you know? And now I'm just another unemployed person in this country. I don't even have a dime.
I don't even have enough for the bus. And you know what, if that wasn't enough, I have to answer for a daughter that I didn't even know existed.
And here I thought I had problems.
And I haven't even begun to tell you all.
If you tell me you're terminally ill, I'm gonna cry.
No, Mrs. Curtis, don't be like that. It's... Well, I want to answer for my daughter. You know, I want to get to know her. I want to hug her every day and make up for all the time that I've lost with her. My ex already has a husband, and my... Well, you know what? My daughter sees him as her real father, and me, I guess, to her, I'm a total stranger, and... But no, don't be like that, Mrs. Dudis. It's not all bad, you know? Except for the lawyer that she hired. She hired a lawyer to charge me for all the child support that I owe her for all these years, and... And yesterday, I thought that I had touched the sky with my own hands. I had gotten a job at Copito Industries, and... And when I got there, well, it wasn't the job I wanted. They offered me the position of a secretary. Can you believe it?
So what? What's wrong with that? A job is a job.
No, but Mrs. Dudis, me work as a secretary?
Emilio, with your hand on your heart, tell me, if you think beggars can be choosers? And right now in your miserable life, can you be so picky? Answer me, you cannot be picky.
Mrs. Dudis, no.
I'll go get your soup right now.
But you are.
Quiet, I'll go get your soup.
But...
Amanecer, en el alma yo te encontré.